So, here we are. This is a little bit of racing I did the other day, and I didn't have a really good, you know, sterile audio setting here, so I just turned the mic on mute, and I figured, well, I'll record it while I just do a little bit of racing in case anything interesting happens. And overall, it was pretty interesting. Still don't know why, when I choose the deadline outfit with my Shotaro, it gives me a different helmet. But we'll go with it. As we zip along here in first. As you can see, Slipstream and Ketchup are both on, probably along with Mustard and Mayo. But we can use that extreme precision of the Shotaro. That's what I like about it. I mean, it does, I think, only have like something like 124 mile per hour top speed, or 121. It's something in the 120s. So you can get caught by other bikes, especially once you're in first. Once you are in first, I'm like, he went to bump me there and it bumped him. The Shotaro is so solid. Look at the maneuvering this thing has. It's just amazing. That guy keeps trying to bump me through the whole race. And there is at one point I bump him back and I kind of felt badly because it was far more effective. We'll see where that goes. Mostly, I think you'll see I try to pass him clean. That's kind of a key thing here. I want my style to be clean. We just glide that a little bit there. Whee! I'm trying to remember if this is the part. Somewhere on one of these kind of strange angled sections, they actually put a bunch of slowdown bars. There's slowdown boosters up there, and you can drive around them if you're very, very careful. And I had discovered this previously. And this gives me a huge edge, I think, in this race, because I was able to go around. We'll see it coming up here. Can't quite take some of these flat out. They're really tight. One gets the impression that these tracks really are built for the faster vehicles. There they are! If you go right on the edge there, you can go around them and it gives you a huge advantage. But there's a lot of long straightaways, but there's something about having a vehicle that handles well in the corners. It just seems to, things go well. I mean, if you have something that can handle well. I've been experimenting with a Banshee 900R, and I still seem to be getting, even on these really long straightaway tracks, better results from the RE7B. Now that may simply because I don't know how to drive a Banshee 900R, but for this one, I just jumped over the booster a little bit. That'll cost me. Got a boost there. I'm probably running a little bit down on speed compared to the team here. Woo! Just get down on it. We don't want to fly off into the water. I get down on it. We just want to party with you. This is a pretty narrow launch here into a nice purple landing areas. I wonder what the philosophy is behind when they're trying to come up with one of these tracks. You think it's kind of wing it, or... Okay, clean lap in first. Trying to maintain things here. I don't know why I jumped over there. I don't know if I actually was looking at the radar and then jumped over. I just had an instinct, or whether I just twitched. But it kind of worked. I think he would have hit me otherwise. Now we're zipping around here. See, bang. It's like, dude, come on, pass me if you can pass me. Just drive around. There's lots of room. Okay, so I let him take the straightaway. I don't know what happened there. I just somehow hit and was bounced way in the air. He's got the Shotaro with the fenders taken off. Woo! Sorry, we just touched a little bit, and then I immediately tried to get out of his way. I don't want to bump people around. This is nice. This is nice racing. We're neck and neck. Emmy, you know, what's his name? Emmy Goku or something? We're just trading places here. He's trying to knock me off the track. See that? You see? See how he is? Why do you have to be that way? Why? Why can't we all just be friends? I just want to race this thing as if it was non-contact. I just want to fly along here. And I think you can see that last time when he bumped me, it cost him more than it did me. It's, you know. Believe me, in this video, you'll see that is not how it always works out. I get pretty handily beat up in this video. But still just saying. So we come along here. Now, here's what I'm thinking. I could probably really lose this guy. If I can just do everything right, not fall off the wall. Not falling off the wall is kind of a big deal. Second, he's really close. If I can miss the strips up here without doing that. But he'd figured it out too, as I recall. Because I'm thinking, aha, I've got him. I went around him. But he's right there on me. He's right there on me. And look at that. He almost knocked me off the track altogether. And at this point, I'm like, you know what? Heck with that. And now he's gone. Gone, forever gone. Yeah, I lost this little bit of patience there. I was like, alright, you almost put me off the track. Now I gotta protect myself. If you like to play this way, I'm sure you'll... And yes, I don't have a perfectly quiet background in this video either. So, we'll deal with that. But dinner will be good, so we can live with all that. So that's how that works. It's pretty much smooth sailing from here on out. We're sailing. And of course, once you really kind of crush the field like this, that's when the accusations start. And I think you'll get to see that. And I wasn't even going to put this video up, but now I feel an obligation not only to put it up, but to put it up soon. So that you can see that I'm not doing anything bizarre here. There's no hacking going on here. I'm not even traveling particularly any faster than you could expect for the Chotaro. The Chotaro is a fast bike because it handles so very well. I'm not using magic handling mods. It's just the Chotaro. Oh, okay. It's the chick in the short shorts. Hi, how you doing there? And a telephone. Hold on, but we have the magic of editing here. And luckily, the phone wasn't for me. So we'll continue. Whee! Ba-booing. She's just standing up. This fine lady is just saying, hey, look, I've got a cool outfit and a cool bike. Join me in the mountains, where we will zip along. And yay, most importantly, you finished first, which is, I think, the only time. The race before this, I think, was my 400th loss. Good amount of money, we're talking. Ha! There you go. Host is most likely hacking. I was the host. I'm like clickety-clack, people. Base to Black Knight, base in System Services. I've got a funny helmet for this, but... purchased for the upcoming St. Paddy's Day special. Well, I recorded it all and put it on YouTube. So... there would be a record. Like, if I'm cheating, you can see. Anyway, here, comment in the description if you think I'm cheating. Believe me, with the rest of these races, they don't think I'm cheating. So, things continue on. Let's do the time warp again. Okay, so we got liftoff. We got not a full boat. I'm going start, and there's people joining. And you can't start when people are joining. Now you can start. Customs are on, catch-up is on, slipstream is on. It's on, baby. Start! Derp. Okay, so that's... well, you got people going, start! Derp. You know you got people who want to play bumper tag desperately. Your stat time was a minute and a half behind your actual finish in my game. I don't even know what that means. I didn't really look. We'll have to take a look at it. And you can see there is a glimpse of the green machine, as I'll call it, which is going to be used in the St. Paddy's Day special. And you may see it before St. Paddy's Day, but for right now, I don't think I no clue why, but believe me, I'm not that creative. That's it. That's the truth. I'm not a hacker. I don't want to get banned. I make too many videos to risk being banned. There you go. 400 races before that one. Boof. And there we go. Could, I don't know. Could be glitch. And so now we're going to do the liftoff. Okay, we're going. Bang! He just didn't go. I don't know why he didn't go. Now he's going to think I rammed him deliberately. He's after me! And we have a wreck, and another wreck, and another wreck, and another wreck. And we'll see that again in replay here, simply because just at the end of that other recording session, as I'm hung up on the wall badly, you could probably hear a little hint that my toddler had woken up from his nap, and so therefore parental things had to happen. And I lost the sterile audio background capabilities of recording, so here it is. Now it's, look at that. If you get messed up, if you missed one of those boosts, you're dead meat. Okay, well, that's good to know. There's a technique there you can use if you're a jerk. Okay, now. So now here it is. It's a Friday morning, and I'm looking out at the snow. Snowing pretty good out there. Using probably a little bit more golf voice because everyone else is still asleep. School's on a delay, and I have a feeling they're gonna shut that down. It's only snowing harder now. Roads are looking worse. And we're just kicking back here, finishing up this voice over. Now I'm like, I think I'm in last here. If I'm not in last, I'm as close to last as makes no odds. Learning the track. That's the one thing about having a bunch of new tracks. How do you spin out an RE7B? For heaven's sake. Probably just lost the downforce and slowed down too much. But you can try to learn the tracks. The tracks tend to grab you the first couple of times you drive them. Unless you're, you know, purely awesome, I guess. I don't know. Which actually usually makes for a more interesting video. Or it has the potential, at least. Remember when we first saw this set here in, was it Downward Loop? Is that the name of the track? And everyone was like, whoa! And now it's like they use seven of them. It's hilarious. Okay, so here we are back around. This, boing. Okay, boing. Boing. Hooray. Am I on a second lap or they just use the same stuff? I lost track. That's what happens with several days between part one of the voiceover and part two of the voiceover. We're zipping along here. Everybody is so far ahead of me. Let's see. Did I gain any positions on this? Or just finished? Did I DNF this? Trying to remember. We'll find out, obviously. Zip through here. Oh, look at that. We're starting to catch someone. There's hope. Let's see. Did I screw up that hope? Yep. Screwed up that hope. Yay. It's interesting how sometimes the guardrails just kind of, instead of you sliding along the guide rails there, you just stop. People are finishing. I have a feeling I'm more than 30 seconds behind everybody here. Really pushing it, trying to finish, trying to do something, please. Closing again on 10th. 30 seconds now, or the 30 second DNF timer is going, and somehow I fly into 10th. Then to 11th, then back to 10th, then back and forth. And 17 seconds, can we make it? Come on, 11. Yeah, all right, we finished it last, but we did finish, and that was just a happy-go-lucky moment there. I actually typed it up. If someone makes you miss a boost, you don't make the jump. All accidental. It's all accidental, folks. That's keep it classy there, my friend. Yeah, that was just terrible. But it happens, I said. I'm missing a couple letters there, but you know, it happens. If that Ben guy, though, is that a sentence? I think he was trying to imply that Ben is hitting people. Let's see, I think I voted for Plummet 2, but I don't know if anybody else did. There you go. Let's do the time warp again. And they picked Wall Climb, so... As I recall, I thought to myself, I'd better take the car with the most traction as opposed to my top speed green machine. 3 laps. And you know, in retrospect, I really should have thought of taking the Entity XF out on this one, because that has high traction everywhere. It's just a tick slower than the RE7B in top speed, but you don't have that tricky handling with it. It just hangs on. Of course, at high speed, the RE7B will hang on even better. So you go back and forth on these things. Almost a full boat. Let's see, do we get any last minute people? Do we lose anybody? Anybody who can't wait 8 seconds? Let's see. There's always that one guy. It's like there's 5 seconds left. I can't wait any longer. Life is too short. Oh, we got a full boat. Alrighty then. As soon as they join, they're on call. Kick it. Launch that session and let's go do this thing. Or something. Come on. Let's do this. There we go. RE7B. And we'll do ready to play, and then we'll take a look around at the crowd. As you people know, I have a theory that the weirdest outfit will win. Which probably would be the raccoon guy, but I don't think that worked out. But at least it'll be a weird outfit. Something that's visually different. And I think that the reason for that is that people who will spend more time on their outfits spend more time in-game generally, and perhaps have better skills. That's just a theory of mine, which I expound from time to time. A lot of good horns this episode. Here's just... And into the... See now, there's always that guy. I'm trying to sneak my way through, because they're obviously not fast enough. Oh, this guy. That guy, he's just a problem the whole race. That guy in his orange X80, he's just, you see, he wrecked that guy for no reason, too. He just wants to go out and play bumper cars. He doesn't care about the money. He doesn't care about the win. Either that, or he thinks that's how you win. And how you win? Oh! Now, why did they do that? Why did they stick that one little piece of guide rail out so that you would catch on? And by the way, the RE7B has very low traction when you're pulling out. It will spin the tires like crazy because it's all based on downforce. There's no downforce. There's no wing. Then there's this guy. You see how he's just going back and forth trying to block the track? Oop! Little tip for you there. Do not, on that particular ramp, go up anywhere but the middle. Or you're doomed. And I mean, dude, now I'm down in 14th. Barely made that. You see how little space you can do, and it flips you right around here into, I feel like I'm in like a Nexium commercial or something with this purple. I don't know where that came from. But we're just zipping around here. Oh, yeah, I had nowhere to go. Helped that guy out, gave him a jump start. And we got somebody looped out here. All right, we get clean passes there. racing with the bottom of the pack here. Matter of fact, pretty much it's hilarious, because in the first race they think I'm cheating, and now it's just like, let me show you how much I'm not cheating, because I can be terrible. And this is just, what happened there? Someone explain to me what the heck happened there, because I don't think I could have possibly done anything differently. This is just, it's just silly. That's what it is. And brake strips. And then down the hill, wee! But I'm not so last that I'm out of sight of everybody. I'm still competing for the back end of things here, trying to get 13th. And I'm in a section where it's working for me. I'm in this tight turn section. Hopefully I remember here to go up the middle stage. And sometimes, you know, these troll tracks line you up where you have to be on the right or the left, or Chilliad is like that. Trying not to hit him. Don't want to hit him. Bumping, trying not to get out of the way. I'm faster. Come on, through here. Oh, and then we touch him and we wreck completely. And he gets ahead of me. For sheer racing, I do prefer the non-contact stuff. Now there's no reason for that. That's just that guy in the orange car again. We'll just call him that guy in the orange car because epithets are just so off color. You know, we just don't want to have to do that, you know. Now we're still in 14th. Second lap of three. And we're just plowing along here. Whee! Now, as I recall, I had a complete feeling of wanting to get blood from the guy in orange at this point. But you see, he was just trying to... I didn't even have to try there, because he was blocking the track. You will find trolls who'll do that. They'll just try to block the track. Okay, here I just decided to go for the pass. I could have knocked him around, but I just wanted to get past him and away from him. See, that's the critical one. You have to make sure you're lined up on that one. And now I just want to put as much space between me and Bumpy McBumpster as we could here. Bumpy McBumpster wants to bump. What is the theory behind trolling people by that? People are trying to race and you're just trying to wreck them. What joy do you get? Is it just Schadenfreude? Is it just trying to get pleasure off of the fact that someone is swearing at their computer screen? Why? Why would you want this? I don't understand. I don't know. Just past somebody there. Just a couple people there somehow. Must have been a wreck, as they would say. And here we go, down. Kaboof. Overall, I'd say that, you know, the tracks are interesting and fun, if a bit trolly in places, like where you have to line things up perfectly or die. In some cases, a little repetitive, although that would probably, you know, it seems like you do that climb a couple different times, but, you know, that does give a theme to the track. And the theme to this track is a wall climb, so there should be multiple wall climbs. So I'm perfectly good with that. I do like, you know, the overall feel of this. It's certainly a challenging technical track. Try to keep it off the wall because bad things happen here. And the final lap. Hey, a new personal best. And I wrecked a couple times there, so there's still room for improvement. And this is the guy I had trouble passing last time. I think. Slipstream, go past. Right, and now we're into the twisties where I should have an advantage. You'd think. if I have to break that much, they have to break that much. So here we go. Boinkity, boinkity, boinkity. Up to 11th. Maybe somebody wasn't lined up right. Or am I just noticing that I'm in 11th? Is that the... 11th, I think, starts to look like a theme in this one, I think. I'm not sure. If we end up in 11th, we'll have to do a Danielle shout-out for 11-11. If you don't know who Danielle is, she's a to-me local, but probably soon-to-be national country western singer who's just awesome. Eleven was the name of one of her albums for various reasons. And hey! Here we are, racing with a Nero. He's got the horsepower. I got the traction. There you go. Bye bye, birdie. We got people finishing, though. And we're going up a wall, so I mean, that's... problematic. Oh dear! Oh dear! Ugh! Ugh! Again, if you don't go up straight, 12th, maybe 11th was. Maybe just not doing well got to be the theme. And now look at this, looping around. Now I'm trying too hard because I just don't want a DNF, and I feel the DNF coming. DNF, it's dynamite. Oh, we got, no, we did get an 11th. That guy got chuffed into the side somehow. Come on, let's get the Danielle shout out. Can we get in? We got the DNF timer rolling. Braking, pushing hard. Please. And yes, we knocked down an 11th place here. Shout out to Danielle. Woo. And, I'll put a link in the description to her page, because she's cool. And, you finished 11th. Haha, just barely. Just barely. With a 9-11 time. Wow, 11's everywhere. It's just... too bad I didn't get $11,000. That would have been nice. But 8's not bad. 8's not bad. You can tell how much money you're getting out of these double money races. An 11th could pull down 8 grand. My best lap was only 4 seconds off the, you know, it's all 5 seconds off the best lap. So I wasn't too far off. I said, gotta go, good game, guys, gotta go work in the morning. Bye, guy I thought was hacker. That's just too funny. LOL, no problem. I'm not hacking. And you can see here, I'm definitely not hacking, folks. I don't, you know, why would I risk that? You know, I have a YouTube channel where I'm praying desperately that someday I actually get a certain number of like really wild hits on this and I turn into PewDiePie. Why would I lock myself out of the game? Right? Yeah, it's no. We're not doing that. I don't even know. Can you buy a new game and then get back in? Why would I risk even the $60 of trying to get back in here? Praying for a Steam sale or something. No, we're not going to do any hacking. That's just not happening. No. Nopes. Nope-y-doos. Gave everybody the have a great night. I think I was probably tempted to do Green Machine, but nah, I have to get out of there. But I really was. I think at this point, I had to get up in the morning. Boobity-boobity-boobity with my glow-in-the-dark outfit. Glow-in-the-dark. Do-do-do-do-do. It's a glow in the dark. Every time I see that line, just got done beating something small and fluffy to death with a chain, just freaks me the heck out. That's just... I don't know that I could own that car for that reason. It's just so creepy. Where did I end up here? On the ground. I always like to see what happens when I get back on the ground, because... sometimes interesting things can happen. But not this time, ladies and gentlemen. This is your Black Knight. Have a great night.